Okay, so next, let us discuss degree of unsaturation, double bond equivalence, and index of hydrogen deficits. Okay, so here from this degree of unsaturation, we can identify the number of pi bonds or the number of cyclic rings we can identify. Okay, so based on the hydrogen deficiency here, we can predict partially if there are the sigma bonds only or if there are pi bonds are present in a compound, we can know it. So here generally the degree of unsaturation, double bond equivalence, you see this one, CH3, CH2, CH3, it's a degree of unsaturation is zero. Because this one has no unsaturation, this one has no deficiency of the hydrogen. Okay, how you can say there is a deficiency of the hydrogen? So based on the molecular formula of the alkane, here its molecular formula is C3H8. C3H8. That means alkanes are the saturated, those are not unsaturated. For three carbons, there are the eight hydrogen, it is a saturated compound. For suppose for four carbons there are 10 hydrogens, it is saturated compound, its degree of unsaturation zero, there are no pi bonds, there are no pi bonds. For suppose C6H14, here degree of unsaturation zero, there is no deficiency of the hydrogens, there is no deficiency of the hydrogens. For six carbons, so generally that should contain 14 hydrogens. As per the alkane, it is a saturated hydrocarbon, it's not a unsaturated. So its index of deficiency, index of hydrogen deficiency or double bond equivalency or degree of unsaturation is zero. For suppose I am taking C3H6. As usually for three carbons, how many hydrogen should be present? 8 hydrogen should be present. That means here there is a deficiency of the 2 hydrogen atoms. That means here 1 H2 molecule. So here the degree of unsaturation is 1. The degree of unsaturation is 1. Here the degree of unsaturation for this one we can calculate from this formula. The number of hydrogen atoms in alkane with 3 carbons. Okay. If you want to calculate the degree of unsaturation by using this formula for this compound, first for 3 carbons, that alkane has how many hydrogens? 8 hydrogens. And now here in a given compound, 6 by 2, that means here 1. Yeah, degree of unsaturation 1 means it may be unsaturated compound or maybe saturated cyclic compound. That means here C3H6 can be represented as CH2 double bond CH bond CH, okay, or can be represented as cyclopropane, can be written as a cyclopropane. That means here from the degree of unsaturation we cannot predict the exact structure, we can predict the possible structure. With the degree of unsaturation 1, that may be contain 1 pi bond or it may be cyclic ring, okay, 1 pi bond or maybe cyclic ring. Yes, same molecular formula for these two. Okay, so here first for any compound, let us calculate the degree of unsaturation. From the degree of unsaturation we can get the some idea. Okay, that's it. So degree of unsaturation 8 minus 6 by 2. Okay, is it clear? A three carbons, with three carbons in its alkane, 8 hydrogens are present. So 8 minus given, that means the hydrogens which are present in a given compound, that means here 1. Okay, for suppose here C3H4. Okay, yes, C3H4, its degree of unsaturation 2, because here its saturated hydrocarbon formula C3H8, 8 minus 4 by 2. Okay, 2. So degree of unsaturation 8 in its alkane with 3 carbons, we have to assume the alkane C3H8, 8 minus 4 2, that means here 2. So the deficiency of the 2 H2 molecules, it means here degree of unsaturation is 2. The degree of unsaturation 2 means here 2 pi bonds. Okay, 2 means 2 pi bonds. Again here 2 pi bonds means here 2 double bonds or only 1 triple bond. Or only 1 triple bond. Just here we can predict the possible structures. Okay, not exact structure. 2 pi bonds or degree of unsaturation 2 means here cyclic plus pi bond, cyclic plus pi bond or 2 cyclic rings. 2 cyclic rings. Here in shortcut, if there is a one ring, that is the degree of unsaturation 1. Okay, there is a one ring, its degree of unsaturation 1. There is a 1 pi bond, its degree of unsaturation 1. Okay, if 2 pi bonds, degree of unsaturation 2. If 2 rings, degree of unsaturation is also 2. Here 1 ring and 1 pi bond, degree of unsaturation 2. Here we can see C3H4, the degree of unsaturation 2. So these are the possibilities. Okay, from the degree of unsaturation we can get the some rough idea to write the number of isomers. This degree of unsaturation ultimately is useful for the writing number of isomers. Okay, so see this one, the degree of unsaturation 2, it means 2 pi bonds. Those 2 pi bonds may be double bonds or maybe triple bond. Okay, or maybe ring with them pi bond. So C3H4 has 3 isomers. Here with 3 carbons, 2 rings are not possible. Here 1 pi bond, 1 ring, degree of unsaturation 2. Here 2 pi bonds, degree of unsaturation 2. Here 2 pi bonds, degree of unsaturation 2. So from the rough idea of the degree of unsaturation, we can write the isomers. Okay, for suppose. Yes, C4H6. Okay, C4H6. Yes, C4H6, degree of unsaturation with 4 carbons. Okay, with 4 carbons, alkane formula C4H10. That means here 10 minus 6 by 2 equals to 2. So this compound has a degree of unsaturation 2. Here 2 means 2 pi bonds or 1 triple bond or ring plus double bond or ring plus ring. That means 2 rings. They are the possibilities. So based on this idea, we should write the isomers. We should write the structures, possible structures. C4H6 with 2 pi bonds are double bond, C double bond, C bond, CH3. Okay, this is one structure. Next, C double bond, C bond, C double bond, C. That is another structure. Possible structure again. That compound should contain the 2 pi bonds. Here, this one, 2 pi bonds are adjacent. These 2 pi bonds are alternate. Okay, there are 2 structures. Okay, 2 structures. And next, with pi bond, with triple bond, this one. Okay, next, its positional isomer. That is possible structure. Okay, and next, ring plus pi bond, 4 carbons pi bond or minimum ring 3 carbons and 1 more carbon and 1 more pi bond. That pi bond may be out of the ring or the pi bond may be in the ring or the pi bond may be position different. That's it. There are the possibilities actually. Okay, the previous advanced question, write the isomers with C4H6. C4H6, here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 10. Here in this case, another one assumption is left. Okay, this is cyclic compounds with 1 pi bond. With 4 carbons, 4 membered ring is possible or 3 membered ring with 1 substituent. That pi bond out of the ring or in the ring. In the ring, 2 possibilities. Now, with two rings. That means that is a bicyclic compound. Fused bicyclic compound is formed. So total isomers 4 plus your 5. Okay. 4 plus 5, 9 isomers for this, the previous advanced question. So mostly students missing this isomer or this isomer. Okay, that's it. C4H6. Here, by seeing the structure, we can identify the degree of unsaturation. Your degree of unsaturation 2, 2 pi bonds, your degree of unsaturation 2. Here, degree of unsaturation is 2 because 1 ring and 1 pi bond. If there is a one ring, that its degree of unsaturation 1. Okay, because here for the cyclic compounds, there is a deficiency of the two hydrogens. It is a saturated compound, CH3CH2CH3. Here in this case, C3H6, this propene and this cyclopropane is also present. It is a saturated, but there is a deficiency of the two hydrogens. So that's why degree of unsaturation 1. One H2 molecule is deficient. Okay, that's it. Okay, so it is a propane, it is a cyclopropane. Both are the saturated. Okay, is it clear? Both are the saturated. But here, the degree of unsaturation, nothing. There is no deficiency of the hydrogen. But for this compound, for this structure, there is a deficiency of the one H2 molecule. That's why its degree of unsaturation is 1. If degree of unsaturation is 1, it may be ring or it may be pi bond. If degree of unsaturation 2, it may be 2 pi bonds in the form of 2 double bonds or 1 triple bond, a cyclic ring and pi bond, or 2 cyclic rings. Okay, it is the example. Now here, what is the degree of unsaturation for the benzene ring? What is the degree of unsaturation for the benzene ring? Is 4. Because 3 pi bonds plus 1 ring, 4. Yes, C6H6 calculate for 6 hydrogens, for 6 carbons, how many hydrogens should be present? 14 hydrogens. And here minus 6 by 2. That means 8 by 2, here 4. You can calculate from formula also. Okay. Or roughly 3 pi bonds and 1 ring. So degree of unsaturation 4. And next, for suppose. Naphthalene, okay, it's a naphthalene. What is the degree of unsaturation for the naphthalene? Here, how many pi bonds? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 pi bonds and 2 rings, that equals to 7. Its degree of unsaturation is 7. Now, double bond, double bond, double bond, here double. Okay, what is the degree of unsaturation? Here 4 pi bonds you can see and 1 cyclic ring. So here 5, its degree of unsaturation is 5. Okay, that's it. Very simple degree of unsaturation here. From this degree of unsaturation we can give the, we can write the structure of isomers. Okay, for suppose here you can see C4H8. C4H8, the number of possible isomers. In this case, degree of unsaturation is 1. 1 degree of unsaturation means 1 pi bond or 1 ring. You can see 1 butene, 2 butene, isobutene, possible structures with 1 pi bond. And next, cyclobutane, methyl cyclopropane. So totally 5 isomers possible with the formula C4H8. Okay, that's it. So write down this one. Okay, next. Calculation of degree of unsaturation of compounds which contain halogen. Okay, so here in this case, this halogen taken as hydrogen, this halogen taken as a hydrogen, for calculating the degree of unsaturation. For suppose C3H5Cl. C3H5Cl. That means here its degree of unsaturation with three carbons, what is the formula of the alkane? C3H8. So here the saturated compound with three carbons has eight hydrogens. So 8 minus 6 by 2 because 5 hydrogens and 1 chlorine. The chlorine is taken as a hydrogen. We have to add this chlorine, okay, to the number of hydrogens. So here 8 minus 6 by 2, that means here degree of unsaturation 1. 1 degree of unsaturation means here 1 pi bond or 1 ring. So you can see C double bond C bond C here Cl or C double bond C bond C Cl or C double bond C bond Cl. These are the three positional isomers. Okay, there is a one double bond. Okay, here three hydrogens, one hydrogen, here one hydrogen, five hydrogens. Okay, here in this case two hydrogens, here three hydrogens, here two hydrogens, one hydrogen, here two hydrogens. That's it. Now ring is also possible. That's it. With three carbons, three membered ring is possible. So here total isomers are the four. Okay, if there is a halogen, just consider as a hydrogen. For suppose CCl4, its degree of unsaturation 0. With one carbon, how many hydrogens are present? 4 hydrogens. Here, these chlorines are considered as a 4. That means 4 minus 4, 0. Okay, that's it. Okay, so your question is, calculate the degree of unsaturation of DDT. DDT means dichloro, diphenyl, trichloro, ethane. Okay, no? See the structure in Google and you can calculate the degree of unsaturation. It is a halogen containing compound. Okay, that's it. And next one. Okay, first one. Here, second. Degree of unsaturation of compounds containing oxygen. Okay, containing oxygen. Here, ignore oxygen. Ignore oxygen atoms. Okay, ignore oxygen atoms. We can ignore. That means, for suppose C3H6O. C3H6O. What is the degree of unsaturation? Here, the degree of unsaturation for three carbons, how many hydrogens? 8. Here, given hydrogen 6 by 2. That means here 1. We can ignore the oxygen in calculation of the degree of unsaturation. For oxygen containing compound, just take the hydrogens, but not oxygen. But halogen containing compound, we should consider that halogen as a hydrogen. That means we have to add the number of halogen atoms to the number of hydrogens. Your number of hydrogens is 5 and here 1 chlorine, so 6. Okay, that's it. And next one, it minus 6 by 2. Okay, now here the degree of unsaturation 1 means 1 pi bond or 1 double. You see this one with 3 carbons, I am writing like this. Okay. Here pi bond may be between carbon-carbon or carbon-oxygen. That is the one point here. The pi bond may be between carbon-carbon or carbon-oxygen. Okay. So here, based on this CH2 double bond CH, bond CH2, this is the one isomer. Okay. Or CH2, CH3 bond CH double bond CH, bond OH, that is one isomer. Or CH3 CH2 C double bond O H, one isomer. CH3 C double bond O CH3, one isomer. Okay. And CH2 double bond CH bond O CH3, one isomer. If alcohol is the one of the isomer, then immediately ether also comes. It is unsaturated alcohol. Okay. And now ring with three carbons. This is the one possibility. Okay. Next, ring with oxygen and one methyl substituent and ring with oxygen, one methyl substituent, its position is different. All these are the possible structures. Okay. Yeah, this oxygen may be present in the ring, heterocyclic compound, or without oxygen, homocyclic compound, but OH is there. Same alkyl formula. Okay. So, rough idea. The degree of unsaturation gives a just rough idea. Okay, to write the structural isomers. Okay, that's it. For suppose C4H10O, its degree of unsaturation 0, now 4 carbons, 10 hydrogens. For the 4 carbons in alkane, 10 hydrogens are present. So degree of unsaturation 0. That means here degree of unsaturation 0 and there is a 1 oxygen. It must be alcohol or ether. Here, degree of unsaturation 1 with oxygen atom, it may be aldehyde or ketone or unsaturated alcohol or cyclic ether, cyclic alcohol, all these are assumptions. With oxygen and without degree of unsaturation, it must be alcohol or it must be ether. So let us write carbon, 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 OH. Carbon, 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 OH. Position isomer. And next, carbon. This one. Next, OH. N-butyl alcohol, secondary butyl alcohol, isobutyl alcohol, tertiary butyl alcohol. Okay. N-butyl alcohol, secondary butyl alcohol, isobutyl alcohol, tertiary butyl alcohol. Next, ethers. Carbon, oxygen, carbon, carbon, carbon. Carbon, oxygen, carbon, carbon, carbon. N-propyl, isopropyl. Or ethyl, oxygen, ethyl. These are all the isomers for this compound. Okay, that's it. Now, next, degree of unsaturation for the compound which contain nitrogen. Okay, here let us finish here. Third one, degree of unsaturation of compounds containing nitrogen. Here, number of nitrogen atoms subtracted from number of hydrogen atoms. Okay, number of nitrogen subtracted from the number of nitrogen atoms. It means, for suppose, your C3H9N. Here degree of unsaturation. Actually with 3 carbons, how many hydrogens are there? 8 hydrogens. Minus total number of hydrogens 9. And total number of nitrogens 1. So 9 minus 1, 8. So 8 minus 2 by 2, 0. Okay? You have to subtract the number of nitrogens from the number of hydrogen atoms. Hydrogen atoms 9, nitrogen atoms 1, so 9 minus 1, so 8, okay, that's degree of unsaturation 0, that means it is a saturated compound. It means here NH2 like this, or NH2 like this, or NHCH3, or NCH3, CH3 and CH3, tertiary amine, secondary amine, these two are the primary amines. Okay, amine means it may be tertiary, secondary or primary. Okay, that's it. Next, here one question. Calculate the degree of unsaturation of C3H7N and write the isomers. Here actually degree of unsaturation 1. Here 7 hydrogens, 3 carbons means here 8 hydrogens, 8 minus 7 minus 1. You have to subtract the number of nitrogens from the hydrogen. So 6 altogether. 8 minus 6 by 2, that means 1. Degree of unsaturation 1 means here that is a cyclic ring or maybe pi bond. That pi bond between carbon carbon or carbon nitrogen. Okay. And cyclic ring, that is a homocyclic compound or heterocyclic compound with nitrogen atom. Okay, calculate the number of isomers and comment in the comment box. Give the answer in comment box. Okay. Here, let us discuss degree of unsaturation or index of hydrogen deficiency or double bond equivalency of cubane and prismane. This is prismane. Actually, shape is prism, but alkane. So that's it is a prismane. So it is a cubane, cube shape, but alkane. All these are the carbons. It is a cubane. Okay. So what are the degree of unsaturation of the cubane and prismane? So generally its degree of unsaturation is 1, its degree of unsaturation is 2, okay, its degree of unsaturation is 3, and its degree of unsaturation is 4. Okay, here its degree of unsaturation is 2. Its degree of unsaturation is 3. 3 rings degree of unsaturation 3, 2 rings degree of unsaturation 2, here 4, that means 1 ring and 3 pi bonds degree of unsaturation 4. Okay, here the degree of unsaturation equals to number of pi bonds and number of rings. Here number of rings 3, degree of unsaturation 3. Here number of rings 2, degree of unsaturation 2, you can say. Here 1 ring and 3 pi bonds, so degree of unsaturation 4. Or we can calculate the degree of unsaturation from the formula C6H6. Okay, first let us see this one. Here cubane, what is the degree of unsaturation? Actually, how many rings are present in this compound? Okay, in this cubane, how many rings are present? So totally in this case, here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That means here 6 rings are present. Okay, 6 rings are present. Rings are 6, but its degree of unsaturation is 5. Its degree of unsaturation is 5. Okay, here number of rings and number of pi bonds equals to degree of unsaturation. That is not working for this cubane and prism. Then what is the formula of this structure? How many carbons? 8 carbons. Here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, it's not a carbon, it's a cube shape. And how many hydrogens? 8 hydrogens. On each corner there is a one more hydrogen. So here degree of unsaturation with 8 carbons, its saturated hydrocarbon formula is 18. With 8 carbons, saturated hydrocarbon formula 18. Now here how many hydrogens are deficiency? That means here 10 by 2 equals to 5. 5 H2 molecules are deficiency from its saturated hydrocarbon formula. That's why cubane degree of unsaturation 5, not 6, number of rings 6, but not 5. Okay, that's it. Next, here coming to the prismane. Here the prismane is also polycyclic compound. How many rings are there? Here 1 ring, okay, this is the 1 ring, and this one is the 1 ring, 2, here side, and this side 4, and this back side. So totally rings are 6. Rings are 5, I think. Okay, so 1 2 3 4 and 5 back side only. Okay, 2 adjacent, 1 upper, 1 down, and 1 back side. Okay, so rings are the 5, but degree of unsaturation is 4. Then calculate the formula. Here in this case, carbon, 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 carbon. So 6 carbons. And how many hydrogens? On each carbon, one more hydrogen. So C6H6. So now here, with 6 carbon saturated hydrocarbon formula, 14. So here degree of unsaturation, 14 minus 6 by 2. That means 8 by 2, 4. Prismane degree of unsaturation 4. And cubane degree of unsaturation is 5. Okay, that's it. Those are the polycyclic compounds. Okay, but these two compounds, that statement number of pi bonds, number of rings equals to degree of unsaturation, that is not suitable. Okay, we can calculate from the direct formula. Okay, that's it. And one more compound, double bond here. Its degree of unsaturation is 1, 2, 3, 4 and 1 ring, 5. The degree of unsaturation for this compound is 5. Its compound name is benzophenone. Okay, benzophenone. Because that is formed from the benzene related compound, that's it is a benzophenone. Okay, the number of pi bonds 4 and 1 ring. Okay, but that formula, that statement, number of rings and number of pi bonds equals to degree of unsaturation is not working for the cubane and piston. Okay, thank you. Thank you for watching. Okay, so finally, see these problems. Okay, so write the primary alcohols with molecular formula C5H12O. Okay. Here asking primary alcohols only. That means carbon, 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 carbon. 5 carbons are OH, primary alcohol. Primary alcohol this is. Okay. So change the structure. 4 carbons, carbon, 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 OH. Primary alcohol. Okay. Or carbon, 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 OH. Okay, so again primary alcohol. Okay, next carbon, 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 here carbon, again primary alcohol. So that means here in this case 4 primary alcohols are possible. 4 primary alcohols are possible. Okay, that's it. The names are the neopentyl alcohol, this is neopentyl alcohol. Next it is a no common name. This one is the isopentyl alcohol. This is the n-pentyl alcohol. Okay. Now next here, write the amines with molecular formula C4H11N. What is the degree of unsaturation? 0. Because with 4 hydrogen, 10 hydrogens. Here 11 hydrogens and 1 nitrogen, so you have to subtract. So 10 hydrogens. Same. Degree of unsaturation 0. So that means here carbon, 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 NH2, primary amine, carbon, 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 primary amine with change in position of the NH2. Carbon, change in structure of the, that means chain length, primary amine. Okay. Next carbon, carbon, carbon. Here NH2, primary amine. All these are the primary amines. Okay, next one. Coming to the secondary amines. Carbon, here NH, carbon. Carbon, carbon, NH, carbon, carbon. Okay, next here carbon, carbon. NH, carbon. Secondary amine. Now coming to the tertiary amine. So carbon, carbon. Nitrogen, carbon. Here carbon. That's only one possible. Number of primary amines. Okay, just you have to check the probability. Cyclic isomers of C5H10. Actually, degree of unsaturation 1. Degree of unsaturation 1. But you are just given cyclic isomers. Okay, given cyclic isomers. With 5 carbons, cyclopentane. You have to check. With 5 carbons, maxo ring, cyclopentane. Cyclobutane, remaining 1, substituted. Cyclopropane, remaining 2 carbons, substituted. Ethyl or two different substituents, methyl, methyl. For this one, carbon, carbon, different position. They are the isomers. Now here, all isomers of C5H10, the question is, all isomers of C5H10. It means, you have to write the acyclic isomers also. Now in this case, degree of unsaturation 1. Degree of unsaturation 1. Okay, the degree of unsaturation 1. So that may be one pi bond or maybe ring. So cyclic isomers, these are, and with one pi bond, write the isomers, okay, and send to my WhatsApp. Okay, so that is about the structural isomers and degree of uncertainty. About the tautomers, we will discuss after completion of the general organic chemistry. Okay, thank you.